Good morning, students. Today I'm here to teach you a very important part of chemistry. It's called atomic structure. So it's the fourth part of your Virav Dalal textbook, okay, for standard 8. So in this chapter, I'm going to cover these topics, okay. In this particular video, we'll be covering about the structure of an atom, the postulates of Bohr's theory, about the elements from 1 to 20, about atomic number, about mass number. We'll be studying in detail about the hydrogen and carbon atoms, and there will be a few numericals. Okay, we will begin with Dalton's atomic theory against the modern atomic theory. Now, what did Dalton postulate? He postulated that the atoms are indestructible. Okay, that you cannot divide an atom. Okay, so atom, they said, is the ultimate. Okay, that was what was Dalton's theory. He also said that an atom is indivisible and it is the smallest particle of an element. The atoms of the same elements are alike in all respects. Meaning, if you take one atom of hydrogen, another atom of hydrogen, okay, he said it has to be the same. But that's not the same in certain elements. It is different, as it has been found out by the modern atomic theory. Now, what does the modern atomic theory say? It says that the atoms are destructible, meaning you can divide it further. What are they divided further into? Protons, neutrons, and electrons. So, atoms of the same element may not be alike, as seen in the case of isotopes. So, there are certain elements who have isotopes. Okay, so we'll be studying the isotopes in detail as we progress further. These isotopes are of the same element. Okay, they are of the same element. For example, hydrogen has got isotopes of hydrogen. Okay, so they will have the same atomic number but a different mass number. Okay, so that these were the differences between the Dalton's atomic theory and the modern atomic theory. Now we'll start by studying the structure of an atom. So what is an atom made up of? It is made up of subatomic particles. What are these subatomic particles? They are the protons, the neutrons, and the electrons. Now, where are the protons and neutrons? They are concentrated at the center inside the nucleus. Where are the electrons? The electrons are revolving in circular orbits around the nucleus. So protons and neutrons are at the center. Electrons are revolving in the circular orbits. Now we learned something about the Bohr's atomic theory, postulates of Bohr's atomic theory. Now what did Bohr say? He said that electrons revolve around the nucleus in fixed orbits known as energy levels. Okay, now how are these energy levels represented? They are represented by the alphabets K, L, M, etc. Okay, N, okay, is the number of shell, that is 1. The second shell is 2, 3, and so on. So they are numbered as integers 1, 2, 3 and so on, and by the alphabets K, L, M, N and so on. So electrons revolve in circular orbits. Okay, these are also known as orbits, or they are known as shells, or they are known as energy levels. All the three mean the same thing. Okay, now what did modern atomic theory say? It said that protons, neutrons at the center and electrons revolving in circular orbits. Now the subatomic particles, okay, the protons are represented by the letter P, neutrons by N and electrons you can write by E. Okay, now electrons move around the nucleus in imaginary paths known as orbits or the shells. Okay, now we have to understand that the protons and neutrons, why are they at the center and why the electrons are revolving? Well, because they are at the center because they both have a mass. Okay, they both have a mass. You can see over here, I've put down in this little table, I've put down the name of the subatomic particles, the charge they carry and the mass they have. So if you see proton, it has got a positive charge. P for proton, P for positive charge. So it has got a unit positive charge. Okay, the neutron, okay, it has neutral charge, no charge at all. An electron, it has got a negative charge, so minus 1. The mass of a proton is 1, neutron has got also unit mass, and electron has got a zero mass. Okay, the electron has got no mass, its mass is negligible, and that is why it can revolve in a circular orbit. Okay, it is very light in weight. Whereas the protons and neutrons, because they have a mass, okay, because they are heavy, they are concentrated at the center. Now, I've just put on this periodic table. Don't get worried by looking at it. You don't have to learn the periodic table by heart or something. This is just to make you understand that these are the 1 to 118 elements that have been discovered so far. Okay, these belong to this section over here. Okay, it's to be inserted between somewhere here. Okay, 54. Yeah, here somewhere. Okay, so these are the elements, okay, from starting with hydrogen. Okay, so these elements 1 to 20, okay, that is still calcium. These you have to study by heart, okay. You don't have to by heart the positions, but you should be knowing the atomic number. For example, atomic number of lithium is 3, okay, beryllium is 4 and so on. Okay, this atomic numbers you should be knowing, okay, for the elements from 1 to 20. Okay, here I have summarized this whole thing. I have put a shortcut method to learn the atomic number of the elements from 1 to 20. Now, I've started with hydrogen. This column is giving you the name of the elements. This is giving you the symbols of the elements. This is giving you the atomic number of the elements. And this is the little shortcut that I have made, okay, for your learning the elements from 1 to 20. So here you have hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium and calcium. Okay, so we'll start with the first one. Hydrogen is high, helium hello, little baby brown, cracking nuts on Friday, Nelson's naughty magpie, always sings pop songs clearly after kissing catty. Okay, little funny, but easy for you all to understand. Okay, so you should be knowing that hi, hello. If you know hi, hello, this thing, okay, this little mnemonics, you will be able to get your atomic number. Because in the numericals that we're going to do, okay, we will not be giving you the atomic number. Okay, we can just give you the name of the element and you need to find out the atomic number. And from that, you can find out the number of protons and electrons. Okay, now we'll learn the next concept, that is about atomic number. It is represented by the alphabet Z. Okay, now atomic number, what does it tell us? It tells us the number of protons, okay, which is in the nucleus of the atom. Now, what is atom is electrically neutral, as you have learned. Atom is electrically neutral. What is the meaning of electrically neutral? It has got no charge. That means the number of protons has to be equal to the number of electrons. Okay, so that is why the number of protons is equal to the number of electrons. So Z, that is the atomic number, should be equal to the number of protons, should be equal to the number of electrons. So Z is equal to P is equal to E. Okay, Zippy. So atomic number Z is equal to number of protons is equal to number of electrons. Now, how is this atomic number written? The atomic number is written always as a subscript. Now, C, now understand what is a subscript and a superscript. C is a script. Okay, so what do you write down? Okay, it is known as a subscript. And if you write somewhere on top, okay, it is a superscript. So here this atomic number is written as a subscript. So atomic number of carbon is 6, which is written as a subscript. Okay, I hope this concept of atomic number is clear. We go to the next concept, that is mass number. Now, what is mass number? Mass number is equal to the number of protons and neutrons present in the nucleus of an atom. Now, mass means what? Or how? How much mass the particles contain? So which are the particles? Protons, neutrons and electrons. Now, protons and neutrons, they are at the center of the nucleus. They have mass. Okay. Electrons don't have any mass. That is what we studied. They have negligible mass according to modern atomic theory. So, that is why what will be the mass of an element? It will be obviously the mass of the protons plus the mass of the neutrons. So, A is equal to P plus N. By the way, A represents the mass number. Okay. So, A is equal to P plus N. So, mass number is equal to the number of protons plus the number of neutrons. So, mass number is written as a superscript. Okay. So, I was just telling you about the superscript. So, we write it as on the left-hand side as a superscript. So, on the left-hand side on top, we will write the mass number. So, C is written, C12 is written on top. Here, C is the mass number of the carbon atom. Now we move on to study in detail the atom of hydrogen and carbon, meaning the number of protons, neutrons, electrons and all. So here is a atom of hydrogen and they are giving you H. Okay, H. 1, 1. What is the meaning of this? Mass number is also 1, atomic number is also 1. So P will be obviously equal to 1, E will be equal to 1 and they are telling you neutrons is equal to 0. So Z is equal to P is equal to E, that is equal to 1. A is equal to P plus N, that is also equal to 1. Okay, how did I get this 1? It is 1 plus 0, that is equal to 1. N is equal to A minus Z. Okay, now this formula also you have to remember. N is equal to A minus Z. So, A minus Z, that is equal to 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0. Now, here if you have to study the structure of carbon, okay, the atom of carbon, C12, 6. What is the meaning of that? Atomic number Z is equal to 6, mass number 12. So, Z is equal to P is equal to E, that is equal to 6. Mass number is equal to what? P plus N, that is equal to 12. Okay, 6 plus 6, that is equal to 12. And A is, N is equal to A minus Z, that is equal to 12 minus 6, that is equal to 6. So, that's how we got the answer 6. Okay, now these are the numericals that can appear in your exams. You can get these type of numericals. Like for example, I've given you nitrogen over here. I've given you atomic number. I've given you mass number. You have to find P, E and N. From Z, that is atomic number, Z is equal to 7. So you can say P is equal to 7, E is equal to 7. Now what is N? N is equal to A minus Z. What is A? 14. What is Z? 7. So, 14 minus 7, that is equal to 7. Now, your silicon. Silicon atomic number 14. Sometimes we will not give you the atomic number also. Okay, you can make it out from high, hello. You can find out the atomic number. Mass number is given 28. Okay, you have to find P, E and N. Z is equal to what? P is equal to E, that is equal to 14. N is equal to A minus Z, that is equal to 28 minus 14, that is equal to 14. Okay, so this is how the numericals can be solved in your exams also. So that's all for today. I hope that you found the session very helpful. Okay, see you again soon. Thank you so much, children. Bye.